Bonjour, I'm Bonky Bilel, a French graphic designer and lettering artist. This video is a preview from the course I created to master Procreate called the Procreate Guide, and I will talk more about it at the end of this video. One of the most difficult things to do as an artist or a graphic designer is keeping your workspace organized, because after several months of using Procreate, you can end up with all your artworks accumulating in your gallery. And it makes you waste more and more time as you go if you need to research your previous paintings. While with a few good practices up front, you can free your mind with a clean gallery. So in this lesson, I will show you how to manage your gallery in Procreate. The first thing you can do is to name your artworks. To do this, you have to tap the name of the artwork below your canvas. And you can even use emojis if you want. To move a canvas, tap and hold it, then drop it wherever you want in your gallery. You can move multiple artworks by picking one canvas, then tap other canvases to pick them too. If you see that one of your artwork is not in the right orientation, you can rotate your thumbnail with two fingers. But as you can see, sometimes it can stretch the thumbnail weirdly. So, my advice is to directly open the canvas by tapping on it. Rotate with two fingers to orient it correctly. And when you come back to the gallery, you can see the thumbnail is now in the right orientation. You can pinch an artwork to quickly preview it, and by swiping to the left or to the right, you can preview your other artworks. If you want to look at specific artworks, tap Select Mode, choose the artworks you want, then tap Preview. You can tap to make visible arrows to switch from an artwork to another. And if you want to open a canvas from preview, you just have to double tap. To organize your workspace, you create a group of artworks called stack. You can create a stack in two ways. When you are on Select Mode, tap the artworks you want to group. Then tap Stack. Or you can grab a canvas and put it on top of another canvas. And when the bottom canvas turns blue, you can drop your canvas and it creates a new stack. To add more artwork to a stack, you can do the same thing. The bottom stack flashes blue, it opens up, and you can drop your artworks. As you can see, those two artworks are not a stack anymore. It means that you cannot put a stack in another stack. You can leave a stack by tapping the stack name at the top left. You can rename a stack the same way as an artwork. Tap below your stack to change the name. If you want to move artworks out of a stack, pick artworks you want and tap stack with another finger, then drop them to another stack or in the gallery. When you swipe on the thumbnail of your canvas to the left, you can see three options: share, duplicate, and delete. I'm going to focus in this lesson to duplicate and delete. To duplicate a canvas, tap duplicate. You can duplicate multiple artworks at the same time with the select mode. To delete a canvas, it's the same process. Swipe to the left, and not the right, it doesn't work, to choose the delete option. You have to confirm twice to delete an artwork because this cannot be undone. There's no archive place, so be sure to delete an artwork if you want to. You can also do the same action with multiple artworks at once with select mode. And by the way, if you want to restore example artworks, tap Procreate at the top left, then restore example artworks. My recommendations to keep a clean workspace is to create each stack for a specific purpose. For example, here is the three stacks I use. I have one stack for all the ideas I have for artworks, tutorials,
and courses I want to create. A second one where I keep all my artwork pieces finalized, like that I can easily show my work to a friend or even for me to see what I've done so far. And the last one is a backup of work in progress ideas. And from time to time, I clean those stacks by delete artworks I don't need anymore or store them in a folder on my iPad. I will show you my full process on how to store your artworks in your iPad later in this course. You can be inspired by my rules and you can create your own too. Do you want to create each stack by color or different subjects like architecture, nature or animals? Do you use Procreate for different mediums, like a stack only for your Instagram posts, one only for your YouTube videos thumbnails, or even one only reserved for your prints? If you like to create several backups to see the progress of your projects, you can also create a stack per project. It's up to you. Finally, to customize your stacks and to keep a clean workspace, I can show you how to create a cover for your stack. Let's say that you want to create a stack specifically for your letters artworks. Grab all of your artworks and create a stack. Go inside your stack and tap on Square Canvas from your templates. Tap the range symbol at the top left of your screen, then add text. Choose the color you want. Tap the name of your stack. Tap the letter A in the middle right of your screen to change the font. I advise you to choose a bold font and I'm going to choose Futura Bold. Put the size you want. Tap Done in the middle right of your screen. Tap the arrow symbol at the top left menu bar and drag your title in the center of your canvas. Go back to your stack and make sure that your square canvas is the first canvas at the top left of your stack. Go back to your gallery, and voila! A clean workspace ready for your future artworks.
Voilà! I hope you have found this video helpful. If you want to learn more about Procreate, I have created a complete course called The Procreate Guide to Master This Software with a private forum where I answer all your questions. If you're interested, the link is in the description. Otherwise, you can still look at selected beginner lessons from the Procreate Guide thanks to the playlist on the right. Until the next one, bonsoir!